Today, I will provide an overview of the Exploration tab of Simulx, which allows to explore a model by interactively changing treatments and parameters and check the result on a typical individual. In this example, I have loaded a joint PK and tumor growth inhibition model from the library. In Exploration, we can see a prediction of the model based on the elements selected in the left panel. The only mandatory elements are parameters and outputs. If the model contained regressors, then a regressor element would also be mandatory. Only one parameter element can be selected, and it has to be individual parameters, not population parameters. Here, this corresponds to a set of typical parameters that I have created. The parameter values corresponding to this element are also displayed on the right. It is possible to select different output elements, and in the middle panel, one plot per output is displayed. Here, I have one output element for the drug concentration, a variable named exposure, and an output element for the variable TS, which is the tumor size. Each output also contains a time grid for the simulation output, here dense measurements between 0 and 200. In exploration, only non-random continuous variables can be used as simulation output, which means that categorical or time-to-event variables cannot be selected, as well as continuous variables with random residual error. In addition to parameters and outputs, I have selected a treatment element containing a single dose with an amount 100 at time 30. I can actually select several elements among all the treatments that I have created, either to combine them in the same simulation. For example, here I add a second dose with the same amount at time 100. I need to click on Apply to generate the predictions with my new selection. Or I can also select a treatment in a different exploration group. For example, here I select this multiple doses element in which 10 regular doses with an amount 30 are defined. In that case, it creates separate simulations displayed on the same plot with a new color specific to the exploration group. In addition, I can define an exploration group with no treatment to check the prediction of unperturbed tumor growth. The exploration group titles can be modified and their colors correspond to the different predictions. I can also display a legend on the plot with this button. Let's now have a look at the right panel. Here, I can interactively explore the impact of the parameters or the treatment on the predictions by changing their values. I will first focus on parameters, and I will, for example, increase the killing effect of the treatment on the tumor cells K-kill. I can use the arrows next to the fields, or I can enter any value. This does not modify the element in div params, but only the current predictions on the plot. I can come back to the initial parameter values in div params at any time with this button. What happens now if instead of a single set of parameters, I have loaded in Simulx a table of individual parameters that I would like to use in exploration? This is also possible. In the parameters section of the tab definition, I have an element called IndivTable that I can view with this button. This table corresponds to sets of individual parameters that I have estimated on individual data in Monolix. I can select this element in exploration instead of my vector of typical parameters. In that case, a slider appears to select the individual I want to focus on. By default, the parameter values here come from the first row in the table, but by changing the ID, I can change the row used to get the parameters. I can modify the ID with the arrow or by dragging the cursor. If I want to focus on the treatment, I should first select the element that I want to play with. Here, I will explore the multiple dosing schedule, and I will check if I get a similar effect on tumor size if I reduce the dose density by half for the same cumulative amount. To compare the predictions before and after modifying some values, I can create reference curves with this button. Now, I can decrease by half the interdose interval from 14 to 7. As well as the amount of each dose, and I double the number of doses. The overall treatment effect is indeed quite similar in this case. Note again that changing the values here does not modify the initial treatment element here, So if I click on Apply here to rerun the simulation, this will reset the initial treatment values. I could also come back to the reference values stored here. It is possible to save the values that I have selected here as a new treatment element with this button. This brings me to the Definition tab, where this new treatment will be saved along the others. I name it Multiple Doses 15. On the bottom of the window, there are two options to decide what to do with this element in the tab Exploration. I can either replace another treatment by this one, or add it to an exploration group. Either an existing exploration group, where it will be combined to already selected treatments, or in a new group. I will choose this latter option. I then need to click on Apply to generate the prediction with this new group. Now let's have a look at the Settings panel. In this panel, I can modify the scales of the axis, for example, to choose a log scale on the y-axis. If I choose the same limits on all plots, I can also set my own limit values. On the top, it is possible to modify the default display of the variables on the plot, to focus on one of the variables, or to have the drug concentration and tumor size on the same plot. This button allows to reset the selection to default. Finally, if I want to reuse all my selected elements to compare the different treatments in populations of individuals in the tab Simulation, I can click on this convenient shortcut to send all these elements to the tab Simulation. I can now move to Simulation, where simulation groups derived from the exploration groups have been set up with a group size of 1 and the same parameters and outputs. Now I only have to choose the size of the groups I want to simulate. I hope you will enjoy exploring your models with Simulx. Have a nice week!